And can we see interest in the currencies? Can we see currencies as one of the good asset classes, or rather gold or metal? Give me this view from the regional perspective as well, like Asia, Europe, and the markets as a market classification as well. You see the developing markets doing better, or emerging markets, or the developed markets doing better. So I'll ask a number of questions, so please update our audience.
Yeah, so I think when we look at asset classes, I think, as I mentioned, gold is an area where many investors who are concerned about the future coming out of COVID, et cetera, and unemployment have been going into gold. What we have seen, though, is there's been very good performance in certain markets during June and also in Q2. So if you look at Hong Kong, had one of the better months in June compared to other markets. We also see that investors are looking at which countries have dealt with or are dealing with COVID better than others. So if you look at New Zealand, you look at South Korea, and some of the other markets where they've controlled COVID, and they have the technology in the country as well as for individuals so that education can happen remotely. I think those are some of the things that people are looking at, which countries are going to recover faster. And we also see that as the weight within indices is changing, there is an increasing interest in looking at what is happening with China opening up as an investment platform. They've made it easier for many investors to invest directly. It used to be you needed quotas. When we look at markets in Europe, we saw that the Netherlands and Germany have done well during the month of June. And I think there still is some concern for the UK in terms of not just COVID, but what happens with Brexit, right? So what will the negotiations lead to as the end of the year approaches? Will there be trade deals, or will we end up seeing that we're at the WTO standard?
Okay.
So there is uncertainty for the UK there.